things are looking up here in the Bush Bee Man show. I've even lashed out, got a tape measure, I've got a notepad, and even a pen. Now you may be wondering why a bloke would get that excited, because it involves spending money, so I have to actually get a little bit of measuring shit done right. Because if you've been watching along with us and you see me make that crazy bloody hive out of a fridge, the intrepid cameraman who happens to think it'd be a great idea to make a, what do you call it, a view hive, or a, I don't know, anyway, a view hive, sounds a bit rude, but anyway, it's somewhere so you can actually check out the girls. So I've been looking around and trying to work out a way to do it, and I was going to make it in a fish tank, which we still might do. I'm no ruling that out yet, but that's not what we're going to do at the minute. So I was looking around the yard and I found these couple of glass windows, and I thought, well, maybe we could make an upright observation hive, I think he called it. We could make it an upright observation hive. But anyway, we've got to do a bit of measuring and a bit of shopping, and we'll see what happens. And hopefully we're not at this for about 3.5 years, but who knows? Anyway, so as you would know, if you've been watching this show, nobody throws anything away on my farm. And I bought these bloody windows that didn't quite fit a project that I had in mind, because they were for my outside room that didn't quite pan out. And I was looking at them the other day and I thought, they're nearly the right size. Like, for this observation hive, I can make the frames across here and make a tall one. Make it so it's long and skinny, a bit like when we catch them in the wall cavity. I thought this might be ideal. So we've just got to figure out how high and how wide.
So we've got to go with, what are we going with here? We're going with 15.
1,500 for the important people. So, talking about 1,500 mil. I was stuffing around doing my cementing for my outside area once. I was thinking about how, like 10 meters, but according to the way they put it in their system, because I was not talking in meters, I was talking in millimeters, I got a wheelbarrow full of cement in the back of this massive big cement truck, and they dropped it in my little pot, and I went, I think I messed that shit up. So then he said, oh damn it, he's got other orders to do. And foolishly, if ever you get a little wheelbarrow full of cement and you didn't want it, don't do anything dumb. Just go fuck off and come back tomorrow. Because he came back at about 10 that day with the load that I really wanted. And it was 47 degrees in the shade here in the Riverland. So by the time the wife got home, I was laying dead on the corner of the concrete going. It was the very bad day for me. You're lucky I didn't die, otherwise you wouldn't have to endure the Bush Bee Man. It would have been the flat out dead concrete man. That would have been a real short series. Dickhead messes up cement load, does the cementing in 44 degree heat, dies. I might have made the paper, maybe. God, anyway, 560. We're going to make it 2 frames wide. Obviously we'll box this in a little bit so that this will just be the edge. And we'll sit the glass on there, and hopefully we can make a bloody hinge off of this without smacking the... We've got 4 to pick from if we break one anyway, so... So here we are with me fancy plan. Look at that, I've even drawn myself a plan. That's pretty amazing, isn't it? Scary thing is, I was trying to make a bit of humour and the lad said, shit, that's a bit flash for you, Dad. So...
Oh. I don't know how snazzy a timber do you reckon you need?
Maybe we need a tape measure. People tell me that my woodworking's crap, they'll be quite right. Because I'm not the best at this. Where's my father-in-law when I need him? You can buy an observation hive on the internet, apparently, but they're about $900. I wasn't feeling that enthusiastic. Plus, if we just went and bought one, well, you know, we wouldn't chew up another 5 episodes of some other nonsense that we're not sure that we're doing. I've just noticed all the really good shit's at the back. I might just leave it here on the cement. So I'm thinking the first part of the project might be to actually get the windows over here and see if the bloody things aren't completely scratched to buggery, otherwise this project will be pointless. So the young photographer would like to let you know. By the way, thank you all to the Patreon supporters, because we've decided that this project is something that you might enjoy seeing. So thank you for helping out with all your support, and we're just putting some of that, well, not all of that, but you know, a little bit of that money towards this project, so you can see what the bees do when they're actually hiding inside their hive. Well, hopefully you can. Bit of recycling going on here.
Goodness me.
Hopefully they're not too sad, these windows. So being that I'm not actually working from a written up plan that's only up here in my head, I'm making shit up again, as you can imagine. So I've decided that we're gonna router out some little strips for the frames to sit in. I bought two lots of wood, just so it's wide enough for the actual to fit my window frames, which is a little bit slack. If you're making this professionally, of course you can get your glass cut the right size. You don't have to dick around with all this madness, but you wouldn't believe it, folks. I even made a little bit of a space on my workbench. I guess the first thing to do is to cut them the right lengths. That'd be a good place to start. Now, just staying true to my nature, just noticed the lovely wife has left her little circular saw out here, so I think we might borrow that for this project. Hopefully we don't blow the poor little thing up.
That'd suck, wouldn't it? Imagine that. What the bloody hell happened to my saw? I don't know, darling, I didn't touch it.
That pin there, look it up.
What's on that snozzy?
That's a bit bloody Star Trek. Mine hadn't got one of them left on it anymore. I smashed it off years ago. You can see how bloody level my bench is, obviously.
Oh, I tell you. Yeah, we. I
wonder if that's going to be the right height. That's nearly the right height, that bit of my little bit of crazy aluminium in here. Look at that. Now, you know what? I might bolt her circular saw to the end of the bench, because this bit of shit that's in the corner, you know, I never knew what that was for, this bits of welded on angle iron. But now it's the perfect height for, it's not the right height for my old one, well, because it's a little bit bigger than this thing, but it's a perfect height for hers. So I reckon it was made to measure. Nobody out there tell her, all right? The other really cool thing I was thinking just then, good thing about borrowing your wife's equipment is she hasn't smashed shit off it. She's even got the little lockdown bit still that works. How bloody good's that? I have a sneaking suspicion we might be buying her a new one after this. But anyway, hopefully not. I reckon we'll make that just this inside panel part, and then we'll figure out how to square it up so as we can keep the lady sealed up. But we've got to have one edge here, so we can put the hinge on here. So that has to be actual, the right edge, and then the other bit will finish. So the glass will be slightly big for what we're doing, but. So when you see it slightly big, it was already planned to be slightly bigger than it needed to be. The one thing I hate about working with wood is that you actually have to get shit right the first time. Because if you're making this out of metal and you screw shit up by a couple of mil, well, you can just weld that crap up, get an old bit of bolt and weld the hole in. But when you're working with wood and you don't get it right, you ought to go back to the shop and buy another piece. So my father-in-law would tell me, measure twice, cut once. The wild bushman, half the time he measures once and cuts twice. That's I wonder if that's how musical instruments got made up. Heads and shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes, knees and toes. Ah, heads and shoulders, not the toes. I'm such a bright spark, I couldn't measure that and divide it by the length of this, because then I'd end up, I don't know, I'd get confused, so I just thought I'd do it old-fashioned.
Ah, bloody hell.
Would, in theory, make it square across the top so it looks half reasonable when the father-in-law checks me out.
Pete.
I was just thinking this might be a good entry point. What we might do is we might move all the frames down about, I don't know, 20 mil from it, so it's not right at the top like that. Because I'm a bit worried we're going to rip the edge of that board off up there. So if we end up with a bottom frame there and we make that place where the girls enter from, but then the only trouble with that is then the entry will be low outside the shed. But I guess in a bee nest they're normally, you know, they're low outside anyway. So hell, we might mount this thing off the ground a bit anyway. So we'll sit it on a table so we can film it a bit easier.
Hey, shut down in flames.
Well, that's typical. The one spot where you want a router, it's a bloody knot.
Gosh, shit.
Does that mean we've got to go from the other end where there's no knots? Because that's going to be crap. I know all that in there. We'll send the router through there and we'll rip a bloody great hole through here.
Typical. Typical, typical, typical. After all me measuring.
Ah, I don't know. It's a travesty. I'm hoping it was 1440. If it's not 1440 and I'm bloody wrong, then we'll be in trouble, won't we? Right, there's a knot-free zone, look at that.
It's not a bad life, this agricultural gig. My beautiful wife, she's off at work, bloody getting all organised. She loves her job, by the way, which is really cool. But, and we're dicking around in the shed here making an observation hive. I mean, it's pretty good. It's not a bad life, really. Thank you very much, all you guys. Because I'm, you know, I've had some messed up shit going on in my life. This is actually good fun to have something to do with me, lad.
Listen to this guy, and he was on the radio talking about back in the day, when he was a young fella, I guess. No, he's probably, hell, I'm probably back when I was a young fella, for that matter. He was saying that they used to give everybody
a jacaranda tree as a birth present, like to remember the birth of your baby.
And I thought that was kind of cool. And then he was saying there was a certain suburb, I reckon it was in Sydney, that had a whole road of all these cool jacaranda trees that people had planted after their babies were born. How groovy an idea is that? So if you're out there having a baby, maybe nip down the shop and get yourself a flowering gum so that actually that gum tree is going to be alive when your grandchildren are kicking around and the bees will have something to eat into the future. So there's a thought. So you'll have a memorable moment for your kids. And actually when they're old enough, you could take them down the road and say, check out those bees having a nibble on your tree. How cool would that be?
Well, I'm just trying to work out. We're going to have to router a hole for the frames to sit in. I'm just trying to work out how bloody deep to make the damn thing.
Guess we make it almost deep enough for that to sit in there, so as it can slide in and not fall out. That's the plan, isn't it?
I reckon what we need is something that's 10mm thick that I can just put next to that.
So I know what we're doing.
And I've got a pissy little rotor blade, so I'm going to have to do a few passes. Which could be interesting. I don't know what happened. I have a box with rotors in it. And I actually have another cool handheld router. But that's in this shed somewhere, buried under bee boxes, I think.
We might even be able to use those bottom bits we cut off for the side bits.
We'll be very practical.
Yeah.
We ought to go into bulk manufacturing. A bit dodgy, but it doesn't look too bad. We might just slip the frame in there before we make all of the cuts.
That's a bit bloody awkward seeing what you're doing.
That should work.
Hey. If we get the bloody thing square, that'll be interesting, otherwise it'll be like that. Mind you, the chicks don't care. They don't care if it's on an angle. Quite often they build their own stuff on an angle, but we just want them to be uniformed and bloody do as they're told, but of course, thing to keep in mind if you're a beekeeper is that they're actually insects and they've got a mind of their own, even though they're only little. If we can manage to get it square from here on out, we might be somewhere near it. What do you reckon?
Getting the hive tool in this bloody thing will be fun, won't it? We'll probably have to invent a whole new special bloomin' viewing box hive tool.
Well, hell, never know, there might be a market for that too.
So we're just gonna have to square it all up, cut the support beams across the top here, 35 mils longer each end, so as we put another beam in here, because we have to have another beam to hook this to, just so as it fits on the window. If you didn't have to do that, if you had the glass just the right size and had a special frame, well, you could probably just do this bit and save the aggravation of the next excitement that we're going to have. But then ultimately it wouldn't be a recycled view hive. Observation hive. That's what it was supposed to be called. So technically this is the top, but it might end up at the bottom, the way it all fanned it out. And then I'd have to change my letters, wouldn't I? Because I've got a T and a B, so I'd have to put a B and a T the opposite way around, cross it out, chop it around. Just don't tell anybody that we've got that upside down. I'm just working out so that the frames, so you get a bit of wriggle room. You can't have this perfectly, like perfect, but you've got to have it so as the frames can wriggle a bit, but they're not going to fall down when you play with them. So 5:30, but none of this is bloody square anyway. Isn't it typical? If you were really, really serious about this crap, you would probably get wood that wasn't actually bent, but I thought this looked pretty straight in the shop until you start working on it. I wonder if there's different, I suppose there's different grades of pine, isn't there? I'm just thinking the way this is going, we might not need the extra one. This might actually just, we might only need one on one side for the, hook this to. I reckon we're just going to have one beam on the back here to actually hook, to actually pivot on. So we can actually open the bloody door, because obviously you've got to be able to open the door and get the girls so we can do something. If we want to harvest the fucking honey, or play with them, or do whatever we're doing. Anyway, you've got to be able to get into the box, don't you? Can't just have it doing its own bloody thing. But that's actually nearly perfect. Cool. Every now and then you have a win. We were really flashy, we wouldn't have to keep changing the bloody PowerPoints, would we? Oh dear. Now you can see why a bloke doesn't actually make his own actual boxes up. Although I did buy some wooden boxes that I'm making up. I have to trim them a bit. Right. So if we do that, nail that shit together. Now this is what happens, you see, when I've got this shit and I lose that bloody thing, then I'll be in trouble. Okie dokie dokie doke, so that's a bit rough, but that'll work. That on there. Hopefully we'll drill a few holes in here. I think we're just going to drill a few pilot holes, so then we can screw this together and hopefully we can square it up and it will stand up. Maybe. I do. We'll see in a minute. It might work. I was just having a bloody good thought. You know what I should do? I should buy all my tools and I should put them in my wife's laundry and then I'd actually know where the bloody things are. Because then she'd keep me responsible and she'd go, where the bloody hell's that biscuit joiner, Mark? And I'd actually have to be good and put shit back. I think if we just put it across this way so we can get the screw it together, just to see if we can't get it square, that'd be something different. Aren't you? Like I said, I don't think the girls have got to take measure, so we're probably pretty safe. But some people out there are going to be writing me an email and saying, you know, you could have done this, you could have done that. And that's all good fun. I was very impressed, though. I was watching these dudes make a cabin out of some recycled pallets. And I was most impressed because they even recycled the nails. So I thought, there's some kindred spirits. Maybe I'll get all flash, I've got new screws. Well, they're not new, but yeah, new to this project. So we've got a little bit, it's not quite perfect outline. So I'm planning for it to be like that. Well, this will be the front here. And then the ladies, then these little frames can hang on there like that. I think that might actually be pretty cool. What do you reckon? Dangling away like that. And the next one in there like that. Then the ladies can join in there and then we can take some pictures of them on the outside.
Should be quite cool, maybe.
I don't know.
I guess we can't just leave it out in the open like this and hope they land on it, can we? That might be a bit bloody Rhapsody's rule. Might defeat the purpose just a little bit.